going on? Megalis here, driving in my automobile. I probably spend on an average about 13 and a half hours a day in my car on average. I go sometimes 7,000 to 9,000 miles a week. I sell cat litter door to door. No, I don't sell cat litter. What the hell kind of job would that be?
No. I sell spatulas.
I'm a spatula salesman. No, I don't sell spatula. That's a total lie.
And I'm
sorry to lie to you people. I sell rearview mirror attachments where everything's not larger than it appears. Everything's much smaller than it appears. So when you're driving, it looks like people are millions and millions of miles away from you. That's not even true either. No.
Hey, that guy's got a Hummer. He's really important.
The Hummer used to be like a car of status, and you went, wow, that guy's got some money. He's a sports figure. He's got a Hummer. Now you look at Hummers and go, what a dick. I do spend a lot of time in my car. Way too much. That's why I've invented a new automobile called the Carouse, which is kind of car and house, you know, combo. Don't try to steal this freaking idea. So yeah, I got lawyers. It's a car that's got like, the regular stuff, steering wheel, you know, CD player, you know, it's got a little GPS.
But it also has a little kitchen, a little bar.
It's got a shower, nice bed, not a king size, but it's bunk.
All is in a car that's basically the size of a Mini Cooper.
Yeah, I'm gonna make millions and millions of dollars, and I'm gonna retire to Tahiti.
Just like Gauguin did, the painter, you know, the guy who like left his family and stuff and went over to Tahiti and said he was really suffering and doing all this painting and suffering.
He was pretty much doing hallucinogenics and like partying with like 16-year-olds.
Yeah.
He suffered a lot for his art.
While his wife and kids are back in Paris going,
Daddy will soon be back, you will soon be back, you will soon be back.
No, Daddy's sacrificing everything for his art.
Oh, you inspire me so much, I want to paint you. But first, let's do the sexy poo-poo dance.
Oh, come on, a lot of those artists were crazy back then. And you know what? That was part of their plan.
Let's see who could be the craziest.
I am the craziest. No. You are not crazier than me. I am crazy. Look at me, I drink turpentine.
No. I am the craziest artist.
Yeah, I'm wearing underpants over top of my robe. Look at me, I'm crazy.
I have not bathed in 1 year. I am the maddest artist.
Yes. Look at me, I'll cut off my ear. That is some crazy shit. I'm not going to top that, no.
So you have to be nutty to be an artist?
Can't hurt.
I don't know about being crazy, you know. I think it's just more important to be absolutely miserable half the time. Just a total miserable bitch.
I think if you're like happy and like, oh my God, everything's great.
Then you're just painting cats like hanging on tree limbs going,
hang in there.
Because turmoil feeds the art soul.
Now, I was happy once for like an hour.
And then it ends back to your miserable bastard self.
But I try to be happy. You know what? I'm a good actor. That's what I am. Because even when I'm like down, I'm just like,
Me, I'm so happy.
Stop with this singing, all right? Stop it.
Back to driving.
So yeah, we spent a lot of time in our cars, way too much time.
Driving used to be where people were just like,
hey, look, I'm in my horseless carriage. How are you? Hey, good to see you. Want to get a ride?
Load up for Sunday drive, everybody. Hop in. Get some ice cream.
Now everybody's miserable. Everybody's driving.
Get out of my way. Get out of my way.
Everyone's going somewhere. Everyone needs to be in their car.
Most cars have one person in the car.
You know, they're like, I gotta go to the bank, I gotta go to the gym, I gotta go to the amusement park.
I gotta
drive and get a pay.
My coffee.
Drive-throughs,
as I've discussed in previous videos.
Totally eat ass.
You got no time to like park and get out of the car and get a coffee?
Or a sandwich?
Which brings me to my car again. My car that I've invented will have a little lunch counter.
No reason to get out of your car. And I'm gonna capitalize big people.
And I'm gonna make multi-billions of dollars.
And then you know who's gonna buy me?
Google.
There's no business like Google, business like no business I know.
Oops, sorry.
Probably not a smart idea to be holding the camera while I'm driving. So where was I freaking talking
about?
Oh
yes, I was talking about my father. Yes, he was a rabbi. And he ended up coming to this country. And he ended up opening a chain of women's lingerie shops.
And then also like a side business where he was doing lawnmower repair.
Then he ended up fusing the two, doing like a lingerie lawnmower repair business.
Yes, that went very well to one of the repairmen's nighties got caught in the blade.
Really? No, my dad actually was a Greek from Greece and worked in a steel mill.
Oh, same diff. Yeah, my dad really never drove a car. Never drove a car.
In his whole life, never.
Wouldn't do it. I walk on the street, it's more safe, you know, and you don't get too fat. People in the cars, they go, they get fat. I was walking, you know, get the exercise, breathe the fresh air.
I just love the fresh smell of steel.
These cars make you fat and stupid.
And I think you're right, Dad.
Yeah, and no matter how much the gas is costing, we don't give a shit. I mean, we're spending like $3 or $4 on a cup of coffee now.
My dad never spent more than like 58 cents on coffee.
He hit me in the head with a board and throw me in the river before I pay $3.50 for a coffee.
So here I am spending half my life in my car. You're
spending like $6,000 on
coffee. What are we going to do? We're trapped. We can't stop
driving.
You know,
most people's dreams are to retire to an island or a golf resort.
My dream is the opposite. I want to be smack dab in the middle of New York City. Just an old crazy bastard.
Just one tiny little apartment.
Yeah, just me and my dog, Mr. Bubasic.
Come on outside, look out. Come on, Mr. Bubasic.
Oh, hello, everybody. Good morning.
Don't pee there,
Mr. Bubasic. Don't poop on the sidewalk, Mr. Bubasic. He's just a dog.
He's just a dog.
It'll spread around. Nobody will get
Let's
hurt.
Let's go get coffee.
Yes, I'm very happy. You know what I'm happy about? I don't have to drive ever again.
Oh, Mr. Bubasic, quit humping my shoe. Those are nice shoes.